If you'd kept your mouth shut, you could have had a cut.
Mr. Bullock, I don't know why you're here, but I have a very busy day and I do not intend to sit here listening to this.
Open your eyes, woman. This sort of stuff goes on everywhere. Everybody's got their own little racket going, taking a rake off somehow or other. I was just getting my little share when you got in the way.
I'll give you the option of leaving now, or I'll call the police and let them remove
you. Don't scare me.
We were wondering how you'd feel about taking a seat on the Supreme Court bench.
Well, the opportunity of a lifetime.
Of course, it would help if you dropped the Daphne Graham case.
It's my mother. She's in the hospital.
Hospital?
I had a call at work. She's taken a massive overdose of pills. If Dad hadn't found her, she would have been dead by now. It's because of me. Because of us, she hates me.
Sorry, Anne's not home.
I'll wait if that's all right.
No, it's not all right. You'll just have to come back later. Goodbye.
I'm not asking you to entertain me. I just want to wait for Anne, that's all. We could chat about floral arrangements if you like. I hear you're rather good at them.
If you must wait, then wait in the car. That way I won't have to put up with you at all, will I?
Morning, Anne.
Tara! Get a load of this!
What is going on?
What do you reckon, eh?
Is this your idea of a joke or not?
Jealous you didn't have the idea first.
What do you think's going to happen now?
Oh, come off your high horse. Just a bit of a hoot, eh, girls?
Yeah. Little stranger point you let us have this paper in the first place. Now you're blowing it completely.
I always knew you weren't to be trusted.
How are we going to do?
Gutless wonders, it's getting so you can't even have a go at the screws no more. Yeah.
We're going to have to scrap these and print up some proper ones. I want them all brought back now.
Right. If you don't mind.
Get nicked. Since when did you lot become chief official censors anyway?
Since we don't want a charge. Now, come on, hand them over.
Come on, Lex, I'm the editor.
Right off. I want them as souvenirs.
Souvenirs of all the nerve.
Come on, put them in a pile here. Come on.
Well, how are the budding journalists? When does the paper come up?
Won't be long now. We're still doing practice runs.
That's not it.
It's rubbish. First try, that's all.
Oh, here's one.
No, it's not the right one.
Oh, come on, come on. I'm sure it's terrific.
What on earth?
Yes, well, she would have phoned you herself, Dr. Malone, but I'm afraid she's very distressed. So I thought I ought to for both of us. Well, I would like to be able to take Terry to visit her mother in the hospital, but, well, there seems to be some misunderstanding. They said that you wouldn't allow her to... Surely, Dr. Malone, it would benefit everyone if they could at least talk about what's happened. I see. And you won't reconsider? Yes, well, I must say, I think it's very poor that her own parents can't...
What did he say?
Well, she's coming along nicely, but not quite up to having visitors just yet.
He doesn't want to know about me, does he?
Terry, I'm sure he didn't mean that. I mean, given time... Oh, come on, Terry, you're just going to have to snap out of this. And maybe it was an accident after all. Perhaps she didn't really mean to harm herself.
It was no accident. They just can't accept it.
Were you waiting long?
No, not really.
I'm afraid I'm a bit later than usual. I had a bit of trouble with a broken windscreen.
It's bad luck. Look, I hope you don't mind my bothering you here at home, but it's
no,
rather...
No, of course not. Why didn't you wait inside? People would have made you a coffee.
There was a report on the radio I wanted to hear. Pretty boring stuff to anyone else.
Well, what do you think of this? Oh, hello.
Looks rather good.
Interesting. What is it?
Oh, I think it might be a little out of your area. It's called style. I'll leave you both to it.
Well, sit down.
thank you. I wanted to break the news personally. I've been offered a place on the Supreme Court bench.
Ben, that's wonderful. You must be about the youngest ever. Congratulations.
Thank you. I won't deny I've been angling for the job, but I really think I can make a substantial contribution.
I'm sure you will. Look, it's nearly dinner time. Why don't you stay? We can break out the champers and help you celebrate.
Yes, I'd like that. Thank you. It's a big chance, all right, but there's one complication, however. I don't think I could take the Graham case. Well, I don't see how I could. The appointment may not interfere, but the case could all be over by then. But then again, it may not.
Where does that leave Daphne?
Well, I'll be going out of my way to see it doesn't jeopardize her chances, of course. She gets a top lawyer, best advice money can buy. Goes without saying all the legal costs will be taken care of.
I see.
I'm afraid the wheels of the legal profession grind rather slowly. A position was mentioned some time ago, before Daphne's case came up. I thought I'd be free to take it, that it was all swept under the carpet, but unfortunately...
Can't be helped. Can I get you a drink?
Please. Of course, it's all highly confidential at this stage. I'd like to break the news to Daphne myself, if that's all right with you.
You're crazy. You know that?
Just having a bit of fun.
At whose expense? Did you ever stop to think of that?
Got a laugh, didn't it? Girls up in B Block loved it.
What? You mean you handed them out all the way down there? I don't believe this.
It just goes to show it's what the girls want. Sick of having to play goody two-shoes 24 hours a day.
Terrific. You know what's going to happen now, don't you?
So, the screws will be a bit stirred up for a while.
They'll be more than stirred up. They'll be down on us like a ton of bricks.
What can they do? Don't even know who wrote it.
They know Daphne's the editor. But I suppose you've already thought of that.
What do you mean?
She'll get the blame, not you, along with the others who worked on it. You probably had it all figured out. I mean, you've been hassling Daphne enough about being editor.
She was really looking forward to it, Lex. Well, so let her next time.
If there is a next time. You're not going to get away with it, Lexi. I'm not going to let the other women take the blame for your stupidity. You're in this on your own.
So I'm shivering in my boots!
You're getting to be really nasty, Lex.
Daphne's so vulnerable. She's attached to the idea of you being the one to defend her and to chop and change at this stage.
Oh, I don't know. Daphne's responsive to sincere people. I think she'd rather have someone with real commitment to take a case. Someone who wouldn't just walk out on her the minute something better came along.
As I told Anne, she'll be represented by the best in the business.
Someone with a few principles, even.
Pippa, that's enough. Excuse me.
You do know what principles are, don't you, Ben? You know those things people believe in and stand up for? With your sense of commitment, you ought to be a terrific success on the bench.
Must be wonderful to be so perfect. You must tell me one day what the secret is, or does it just come naturally?
You patronising chauvinist.
Well, you get a great kick out of giving it, but you don't like taking it, do you? It's about time you grew up.
Is that grown up enough for you, Ben?
Nothing like equality, is there? 15 all.
Oh, Mrs. Morris.
Joan, something's come up. May I come in?